Okay, now we got reconnected. Are we reconnected now? It says we're connected there. I've got bits going out over there. You gotta be kidding me. Internet problems on my end. Lame. I can spam in my own channel. Oh, brother, that's annoying. It better not keep doing that. You don't say. Dude, Macintosser and Hammer Down. Thanks for the follows. Came in while I was gone. This internet better not be hiccuping. Echo Ud, Kaj Singh. I broke the internet again. I don't think it was Twitch. It was on my end. I lost the internet connection for a second, and then it took it a second to reconnect. I don't know why. I don't know where, but that's going to be freaking annoying. He better not be doing that during boot camp. I got to do chiptunes again. Zervigo. I just have to refresh it, I believe. Excellente. The stream's back. Okay. We're back in action, it sounds like. We're totally back in action. I appreciate the two follows that came in while I was over there in not online land. Hammer Down and Macintosser. Thank you so much. Nearly at 300 viewers hype. What do you mean 300 viewers hype? I've gotten 300 viewers today? Oh, we're at. I lost decoders. Oh, I gotcha. Hey, they may come back in a second. Watch to see if the decoders come back. With 300 people watching at 9 a.m., we may get decoders back. Is it better to dual aerobrake in polar orbit than plane change to avoid other moons? No, Dora. No, I wouldn't spend the Delta V on the plane change. What you get from aerobraking is gonna be paid off. Well, you could do it, I guess. You could do it, I guess. I don't know. I wouldn't say that it was better to do that. I wouldn't say that it was better to do that. Drop party. You got diamonds. I don't know what that means. I don't know what that means. All right. Anyways, I had set the Kerbal alarm clock. It's 1 day, 2 hours. And I'm just going to go ahead and fast forward on out there for 1 day and 2 hours. Post some pics of why it takes so long. Nice. All right, Kamuji. Go work on it. Go work on it. The viewer count disappeared. That's interesting. Let's see here. That Pro Controller looks so amazing. Yeah, right? That'll totally get him. It says zero viewers for me. Zero viewers to me. Oh, it came back to 224. Ah, that's okay. That's annoying, but that's okay. That's just the internet hiccuping. It better not keep doing that. Back with 224. Now we're at 233. No! So we had quite a few lurkers. It's all right. It's all right. And gone. What's gone? No. I'm not gone. I'm in the US, Scorpion. US, North Carolina. Yeah, I don't know what the deal with that is. Anyways, video should be back. This is coming up in a day, and I'm just fast forwarding out here. Mater! What's going up? BJC Clang lurks. Nice. Yes! Yes! Dora the Exploder, I actually want to do that. Oh, because no people can watch on mobile devices. Eek. Yeah, I don't have any control over that. I don't have any control over that. My bad. That's a lame. I've got a YouTube channel, Philbirth, I do. I do have a YouTube channel. Bam. We've got a lot of people coming back. Just thought Dos get the sub button. No, I applied for it Nightcore Man and they did not give it to me. Yeah, Mater, I am doing it early. I didn't stream last night because of Squadcast and that sort of stuff. Encoders! Did we get encoders back? Bam! Transcoding. Nice, Lazarus. Oh, brother. We're just not time warping through our SOI change here. You're on your iPad. We got transcoding back, folks. That is good. Twitch wouldn't give me transcoding, so we just have to take it. We just have to take it. True Indian Chief. No. Sorry. How can you stream on games except Minecraft? How can you steam on games? Scorpion, I don't understand the question. We're just waiting for this thing to kick in until this realizes what our true and proper orbit should be. We still have a lot of people coming in. I'm still seeing lots of parts in my, or lots of joins in my IRC client. Oh my gosh, we still have zero videos to watch during lunch breaks. Yeah, no, I totally have YouTube. Keep disconnecting from the internet. Try Hunting Pixel. I don't know. We've been pretty settled. What is transcoding? Arctic Troll. Right underneath me. I think it's right underneath me on the screen. Yeah, it should be right underneath me. There should be quality options, and you can actually change the quality so you use more or less bandwidth. There we go. Now we're on an escape orbit, and we have a Julian intercept. So what we want to do now is what's known as a mid-course correction. I'm actually going to click on Joule and set it as my target. That is going to give me this ascending node here. See how it says 1.8, this little thing that says ascending node. It's not difficult. What you want to do is put a maneuver node right there. And then I want you to zoom out. Get rid of that. I want you to zoom out. I want you to focus the view on Joule and come and look at it. And what I want is for the maneuver node to be in the background. Y'all see how the maneuver node's in the background back there? While I zoom in on Joule. So what does this do? This actually allows me to change my Joule encounter using minuscule amounts of delta V. Watch how minuscule amount we have. We can actually go like this. Oops, why am I doing that? I need to be doing it this way. And that is going to bring us into a different orbit. That's not very minuscule though. That's actually a pretty big plane change. Huh. Let's have a look at what's going on here. That was a lot more than I thought. It shouldn't be that much. It may be that we need to do radial in or radial out or something. Let's see. Yes, some shenaniganry of the orbit is saying that we need to do radial in. Interesting. Alright, well, let's go the other way. And then that is not very good, Joule encounter, so then I can probably pull it up or down. Interesting. Let's see if we can do some more radial. Yep, other way. That is weird. Do I not have it on the right descending node or something? I would not expect it to be hundreds of meters per second to do this maneuver. I wonder what I've got wrong here. You see that? That's not how that's supposed to work. Do you ever sleep? I have far too much energy to be one person. What? Wait, don't we have a stream KSP? Hang on, look, we totally have this. Land on for a noob. Oh, codes, you need to get to Minmus. You need to get to Minmus. The moon of Kerbin. Go there and land first. We could do stream KSP, I believe, is the command. No? There you go. Want to stream? There's all sorts of information there. Sorry if I misspelled. No worries. I am a bit confused as to why this tweak is not working the way that it should. Because see, look at that. Pulling those things is basically doing nothing. Let's go ahead and start from scratch. Because I want to come in equatorial. Usually you do that at the ascending node. Is it because we're past the descending node or something over there? Let me just go ahead and put a mid-course correction out here in the middle of nowhere and see how that works. So I'll go ahead and focus view on Joule again. That's Elu. I'll zoom into Joule and let's see if with that mid-course correction out there in the middle of nowhere, let's see if that's better. That's what I would expect. Interesting. That's what I wanted. 5.2 meters per second to fix that. Something about the ascending node there was just not the right time to do that, I guess. There's a direct encounter with Tylo. Dune is a good place as well. Are you putting a base on Jolo? No, I'm not. I'm putting a base on Kerbin. You missed the target or crashed right into the planet? Well, watch. We'll totally get this. That Tylo encounter, though. Look at us flying by Tylo there. And I don't really want to do that. I would really rather miss Tylo. Oh, come on. So it's like you either encounter Tylo or you miss Joule. That's actually going to make it halfway to SOI change. Yeah, hammer down. It depends on the ascending or descending nodes. Here, ascending is near the periapsis. Of course, it will be expensive to correct the inclination. Let me see here. Is it? Because I didn't really look at that. The periapsis or the apoapsis usually has no bearing on the expense for changing that when you're in a circular orbit. So because we're in an elliptical orbit, the ascending node. It must be because we're not actually coming to it there. And we don't actually want to meet the entire thing. That's fine. Yeah, we'll be fine. Yeah, for UK people. It's for UK people. Alright, that should be good. Told you not to do a plane change first. No, we just need to do a plane change later. We need to do a plane change later. Because that specific situation, changing inclinations is more efficient the slower you are. Yes, that is a true statement. We don't need your clap. Synodon is really early in the orbit. Yeah, I think so. It's just doing it going faster means plane change is more expensive. I'd buy that. But wait a second. If that was true, I don't buy that. I don't buy that. Because look. We're now in a mostly equatorial orbit, right? Let me get pretty much equatorial. Ah, because we're not actually changing planes, we're just passing equatorially. We're not going to be in the same plane as that's the difference. That's the difference. I wanted to get into a equatorial orbit around Joule. I did not want to match the plane of Joule's orbit. So I had the plane change in the right place. I had it at the ascending node. That's where you're supposed to do the plane change if you were trying to match planes with Joule, which would cost a lot. That's not what I wanted to do. I just wanted to get into a equatorial pass like this. That is what I wanted to do. So we did it right. I'm a little bit worried about that Patch Connex nonsense there with the Tylo encounter. Let's see if we can look at it. It's still not going to show me going past it, is it? Yeah, shucks. Because I'm focused on Joule right now. I don't like that Tylo encounter. We could always do a figure eight. Adjusting inclination. Your Joule encounter is at near the descending node, so adjusting inclination will have a little effect. I think it was just going to cost me a whole lot of stuff to match planes, and that's not what I wanted to do. Because now I'm not matching planes with this 5.8 meters per second. I'm just going to go ahead and do an equatorial pass. The trick is that I can't get things correctly. I mean, I guess I could use precise node. I usually try not to. There I lost a periaps, but that still doesn't show me what my Julian periaps is because of the Tylo encounter. That's annoying. Had to pop in. Take it easy, Fedzilla. But there's not really a way. There we go. There was one that didn't have a. So what's the periaps there? A million? True Indian Chief. We've said it 100 times. We're going to Laith. Laith is the name of a planet. Laith is the name of a planet. A moon of Joule, actually. Not a planet. Full on. And see, now my periaps is inside Joule. So that doesn't look like there's a way for me to. There's a Julian periaps of 954. Let's see here. Oh, I'm doing normal there. That's not what I need to do. I wonder if this'll do it. Yeah, that'll do it. That'll just get me there a little bit sooner so we beat Tylo. 21, that's fine. We'll tweak it from there. We'll tweak it from there. This is 5.7. What do conics? Conics are how it displays the orbital trajectory. It's basically relevant or referencing which body it's drawing the orbit to. So that's. It basically just draws the lines differently. I really don't have a good explanation for that. I have a lot of good explanations for really good things, but I don't have a good explanation for what Patch Connex is. If anybody has a better explanation, toss it in chat over there. I wouldn't worry about the periaps, it's just the orbit inclination. Yeah, I agree, Dikos Mari. I wanted to get close enough and I wanted to not have that, but we're fine with this, and then we'll tune the rest of it whenever we get into the orbit by burning radial in or radial out. The prograde is what got us. The prograde is what got us. DOS is my new Saturday morning cartoons. So this node is coming up in 187 days. I'm going to go ahead and orient correctly. How do you know how to fly like this? I don't know, Scorpion. I just do it. I'm not perfect. There are smarter people than me. Sometimes I say the wrong thing. Sometimes I miss something. I'm definitely not perfect at the game. But, I don't know. I just like explaining things. Patch conics are a better way to view your orbits. Yeah, but what is it? What is it? Because there are different conics modes. Which mode do you use, you know? Chromosphere is the thing that NASA uses. Oh my gosh. Alright, so there we go. We're basically just doing this. And we'll just put an alarm clock in here and we'll go out and do this thing. Because I would like to go get some breakfast if they're still serving it when I'm done with this landing. A minute out on the alarm. It's going to be a no-second burn, and let's just go ahead and time warp out 487 days. There we go. So we are just time working around. I really need to clean up some of these things. Yeah, one Galen. I've only been streaming for a couple hours. Well, you know, 6 hours or so. 6 hours. Conic is short for conic sections. KSM, approximate trajectories using conic sections. But what is it? That doesn't explain what it is. In real world terms, what is it for somebody who doesn't know the game? Help me come up with a way that is easy to explain it for people who are new, you know? Because that doesn't explain anything. Like, if you understand what you're talking about already, that is an explanation, but that doesn't explain it for people that are new. I'm really missing a good explanation for people who don't already know all the jargon. It's just a different way of drawing the orbits. And it lets you see things relative to different places. Like, in some place you may want to see it relative to Joule, in other places you may want to see it relative to Kerbin. It's easiest to explain whenever you have an encounter with a moon. It's either an ellipse, parabola, or hyperbola, they're called conics. Yes, but still, those are two big... Yeah, the... How it draws the trajectory is relative, including... It may be an absolute line through pace, but it looks... Yeah. See, Johnny. JF Johnny 5 is getting close. Changing your reference point. That's getting close to it. That is a great explanation, JF Johnny 5. It's all based on what you're relevant to, or reference to, or reference... In reference of, I guess. Relative is the word I'm looking for, to a specific body. And it either shows you, like, the orbit as you would be reference to Kerbin, or as reference to the moon, like your pass on the moon or Joule or whatever. I'm not going to crash, Borvian. I'm sorry. I'm not going to do it. I mean, I'll crash on accident most of the time, but I'm not going to crash on purpose just because you type in all caps. Seriously? Oh, brother. I like that. It's like... relative to the moon. It's not the same sort of thing. I'm trying to come up with an analogy or something. You know? An analogy where it's like... No, that's not a great analogy. It'd probably be too hard. Like a rolling wheel, right? If you put a point on the rim of a rolling wheel and you trace it in different ways, like if the axis of the wheel is the fixed point of reference and the wheel just turns, it looks like the point is going in a circle. But if the wheel is rolling along a ground, right? If the wheel's rolling along the ground, then it would actually look like the wheel would go through a curve. The point would go through a curve, like a sine wave sort of thing. I was trying to come up with some sort of visual representation, but that's not... I mean, it's the same sort of thing. Yeah, Dan Forescu, but we're looking for simple. We're looking for simple... answers, simple ways to explain it for people who have never played before. Anyways, we can burn this node. Let's go ahead and focus on Joule. There we go. Focus on Joule. And then I can come over here and zoom in. Spirograph? What does that mean? And then I can just start burning. When you're in interplanetary space like this, the exact time that you do a burn is not important sometimes. But for 5.6 meters per second... There's Cybatech! He could probably come up with an explanation. Cybatech. Explain to us. We had a question earlier. We've got Rapier engines, right? Rapier engines on our craft. Explain to us why Kerbal Engineer says that the Rapier engines have... Like, how does Kerbal Engineer calculate the thrust for those things? That, well, we're hitting Joule, but we'll fix it later. How does Kerbal Engineer calculate the thrust to weight using Rapier engines? Jeez, all of a sudden, all of these things. Is don't worry about it. But it is. I don't like that attitude. I honestly don't like that attitude. There is a way that we can explain it to new players. And I think it's just, it draws the line differently. It's either how you're going to pass the moon, or how your orbit's going to be away from, like, relative to Kerbin. Try not to use the term relative. It calculates the thrust based on the active mode. Does it have, like, a thrust table or something? Where, like, at certain atmosphere, it's certain efficiency, or a certain thrust? Because remember, like, the turbojets and the Rapiers apparently have a different thrust table, like a thrust curve that varies based on speed and altitude. Does it use those? I think it's just how it draws the orbits. It's really just how it draws the orbits. Yeah, Man on Fire, I am at it early. I am definitely at it early. What do we have? We still have 1438 meters per second left in this tank. I'll take it. So now we just need to add alarm for our SOI change. We've got it. A minute out. We've got it. Pancake Fish, Lucifer Wolfgang, you're a little late. Your men are already dead. Alright, so let's just go ahead and time warp this. How you guys doing on the trip here? Doing okay? We got that? Yeah. Don't they use log curves? I'm not sure. No, this is not live, Scorpion. Sorry, it's not live. Sentence will always be insufficient. You need lots of visuals and paragraphs. Mayor of Space, I don't buy that. I don't buy that. There's always a way that you can explain a technical topic to somebody in non-technical terms. It may not be exactly perfect, like for a scientist who's got their, like, extra PhD or something like that in it. It may not be perfect for that scientist, but it'll get somebody who's not a scientist close enough to understanding what it is. What the options do in a specific mode where they are in. It's really just, it changes it based on, I'm not an astrophysicist. Nian Sam Owitu Yawi. I'm not an astrophysicist. I just believe. Whoa! Text explosion on my screen here. I have to have epic music to read this. When you compare your path to a small lathe encounter, it looks insignificant, but if your frame of reference is lathe, it looks more orbital. Car from the inside. That's what I'm looking for. If you're looking at a car from the inside, it looks like the world is moving. If you look at a car from space and the car is moving east, it looks like the car is moving in faster because the Earth spins. Looking at a car from a point on Earth, we see it's just the speed going it. I'll buy that. They think it be like this, but it don't. But when it do, it does. Yeah. That makes sense. It's like... The wheel is the best example I've come up with so far. Like, a wheel, if you're attached to the hub of the wheel, it looks like the thing's going around you. Oh, brother. Easy peasy. I've got buttons. Chill out. If you're on the wheel, it would look like you were going in circles, and if you were fixed in the middle and the wheel was rotating, it would look like the point was going in a circle around you. But if you were outside, you could see it going up and down and up and down. Like, that may be the best, it's just arc lines centered on a particular point. You need to take off. Take it easy, Irene. Good night, Irene. Oh yes, I'm warping up to my SOI change. That's what I'm doing. I really need to close some windows and stuff. I've got too much stuff running. I hope I can find a place that serves pancakes until 11. I'm not even sure what the question is anymore. It was just for somebody who doesn't understand any of the terminology, what does patch conics mean? Like, changing your conics. What does that mean in how it affects the game. And it just changes the way it draws your orbit. The end. It just changes the way it draws your orbit. And that may not be good enough for, like, an orbital astrophysicist or whatever. That would be an astrophysicist who's actually in orbit right now. But... this is a path if no planets move versus... oh, that's actually... that's spleen. That's actually pretty close. Change the reference mode. Yes, yes, yes. We understand that. It draws your orbit in reference to your orbital body, but in other modes it may draw it in reference to what other body you will be around. Yes. Yes. We know that. We're trying to not dumb it down. That's the wrong term. We're trying to simplify it. We're trying to simplify it for people. I think IHOP. IHOP. Why is this full speed time warp taking so long? I've got lag when I'm in time warp. I probably need to restart the computer or something then. Well, it gives me time to eat. Calls conics mode, it's different ways to draw the conics, nothing more. Yes. But what does that mean? What does that mean? To somebody who doesn't know. It's just different ways to draw your orbit. It's different ways to draw the path you're going to take. It may be relative to curve, and it may be relative to the moon, it may be relative to something, but it's just different ways to draw the path. Simple sentence, bam, different ways to draw your orbit. And it's useful in different situations, like some situations you may want to see it one way, some situations you may want to see it another way. Oh, we could do that. You're nearing the speed of light and time be slowing down. Oh, and I missed your answer, Cybertech. Let me scroll back up and find your answer right quick. You got about 30 minutes till I need to go. Gully Bear! What's up, dude? My grandma has all the pancakes. 4-in-1, that doesn't help new people. That doesn't help new people. We know what it means. We know what Patch Connex means. Invader Spleen was really close. It's like no planets move versus this is the real path. Ah, that's where the pressure and velocity sliders come into play. I wonder what those things were for. Nice. We're gonna die. We're gonna die. It changes how it shows your orbit to you. I think that's the easiest thing. We're about to land it, Gully Bear. We're about to land it right now. So many text walls. I don't know why we're lagging so bad. We totally need to close some things. I can close Kerbal X. I can close that. Oh, these are the angry triangle things. I'm just trying to kill windows.
Yep. I'm eating another butter.
I am totally eating another butter. Other guy, cut it out, man. It's easy for us to click on you. We don't like to have to do it, but seriously, man. Oh my gosh. Lathe is a moon. Yeah, how many trolls in your chat is a good indication how famous you are. Nice, Cybertech. It's just so easy, especially after we've cleaned it up once and you keep doing it, you know? What are we gonna do? Come to a stop up here? This alarm is in another year? Look at that, we're totally going curveball mode in. Stalker Coffee, back again! Chiptunes Beatles, it's actually not called that. Whichever conic mode you choose, make sure you have solar panels displayed while watching. Oh, Brimmer, we were just talking about how to explain, Hey, oh, I don't have a node. Here, let me put a node on. Conics mode. And conic samples to somebody who doesn't understand orbital mechanics or understand what that means. Because we know that it's, you can slice things in different ways and you can get different paths, blah, blah, blah. We know that, right? But how do you explain it to somebody who's new to the game? I think that the easiest explanation is you don't need to know. But we're saying it's just how orbit. It's just different ways to draw your orbit, different ways to visualize your orbit. Well, it is a song called Because, but look, it doesn't actually say that is the thing. The name of the song here... Oh no, it says Because, how about that? Currently playing Slash Because. Slash Because. So what is it? Somebody named Slash? It's fixing it. It's fixing it. Lathe is lion in... I forgot what language. Really? I didn't know that, J-Dude. Nutter butter. Did I miss anything else? Doesn't look like it. Scrolling back through chat. Hey, that's cool. Yeah, different ways to draw the orbits from different reference points. Yeah, that makes sense. That's like an easy one-sentence explanation. We're basically just loitering and waiting for Jewel to catch up to us, and I don't know why. We should have probably just gone to another... We should have put this on a... excuse me. Yeah, we could actually do that right quick. Look. We should have just gone to the Space Center and fast-forwarded there while this craft was on rails. The KSA party music, nice. And now I'm back awake. And we should have time warped from here while the craft was on rails. The problem is, shouldn't it turn off physics? Yeah, mission control, yep. So annoying. Lace Bath mission. And then we could time warp it from here. And look, this doesn't have the same lag. That is so much faster than being on that craft. It's interesting. I thought that would turn the physics off. I've never actually turned that. Time control mod. Yeah, but I don't... DKO, I don't install those mods at my Kerbal Space Academy sessions because I don't want people to have to install too many mods. Like, I don't mind Alarm Clock and Engineer, right? But I don't want people to have to install 100 mods just to be able to follow along. I basically got like 4 or 5 must-have mods, and I couldn't put Time Control and Super Warp and Struts and Kerbal Attachment System and all these other things. I try to keep it simple. Pi, what actually happens on the screen? It's because it has to render all the parts. But I wasn't even in that scene, right? I was in the map view. It must still be rendering the ship even when I'm in the map view? I didn't know that. I thought that it would not actually load the ship at all. But maybe it does. The Only Cake Man. Thanks for the follow. I appreciate you. Alright, so there's that nonsense. We can delete on close and jump to ship. You don't need Cass. Ah, yes. What's up, Ravila? How's it going? We're about to crash this base on the lathe. Little do these guys know this is never going to work. Don't tell them. Don't tell them. We didn't even need to drop these drop tanks yet. Look how much fuel they have in them still. Is this one full as well? Yeah, wow. Interesting. Okay, so now we just need to wait until we're actually in the correct sphere of influence here. Seconds! I'm just gonna let it go. I'm just gonna let it go. And folks, if you're interested, remember, we're gonna be doing... Your daylight is peeking in. I know, Steve Hanley. It's a window. It's a window. You love TASS. What is TASS? DOS, I love TASS. TASS. What is that? I don't know what that is. I don't think the Rapier Engines are OP. I think the Rapier Engines are going to kill us until we're dead, dead, dead. Ah, yes. LT Haas, it's a, you don't want to warp through the Sphere of Influence because it, whenever you're warping, it basically doesn't do a smooth calculation. It just does, like, point-in-time calculations. Like, okay, advance this much, advance this much, advance this much. You kind of see where it thinks you're going to be. But if you warp through an SOI change, it can completely change your approach to the planet. Like, it won't be anywhere near what you thought it was going to be if you time warp through an SOI change, because it's basically a rounding problem. Look at that, it's still slow in this. That's so annoying. Look, 3x time warp should be going a lot faster than that. Well, that's good to know, though. And then I think I stopped it before I time warped through. So let's go and look at Jewel. Does this have us crashing into Jewel, I guess? Okay. That's not good. I can't scroll in and out. Tell me we don't have that freaking bug. Dust does not tired. Update the demo. No, I agree. I agree. D. Cosmari, I agree. They definitely need to update the demo. I can't scroll in. Well, there we go. Okay, I was just scrolled away in, I guess. So how... We definitely don't want to die here. And I can't focus on this anymore. Here's a good trick. Where's my overlay? Where's the thing that shows me all the planets and stuff? That's very weird. Something is very wrong here. Y'all see that? I should have a... Okay, that's turned off. That's good. What is going on? That is very weird. Superdork, what's going on? Today I'm going to try to get an orbit. You are going to get an orbit if you come to boot camp. I feel like we need to go back to the Space Center and come back to here again. Because we can't actually see what's going on with the ship. That's a little annoying. I hope this game isn't impendingly crashing. No, dude, features only fleshing out and polishing existing ones. Flick back to the Space Center. Yep, that's what I did. That's what I did. I'm also closing some other applications as well. Alright. What's up, Trevor? Should have an FTP with no time warp. What? Oh, a free to play with no time warp. Nice. Oh my gosh. Alright. So now we can go back to the ship. Everything seems very sort of laggy right now. It's typically not this laggy. And it is getting on my nerves just a little bit. What did I miss through the past 5 minutes? Sporpian, if you leave for 5 minutes, we can't, like, freaking give you an update every time. Trevor, I usually don't stream in the morning. I usually don't. Let's see if this works now. Alright, at least we have the other planets. We didn't have the warps. We didn't have the orbits of the other planets. Oh, no. It must just be that we're so far away. Huh. That's a terrible, terrible idea, Cybertech. What you just said there in chat is a terrible decision. Honestly. That is a terrible, terrible decision. And it's going to make less people play the game. And I will be the first to say that. Less people will play the game if they don't have that sort of stuff in there. And I will get on the phone with whoever I need to, because the reason less people play this game is because it's too intimidating. And I think that my stream proves that. Waiting for DOS to close OBS. I think my stream proves that that is a terrible, terrible way to think about things. It really is. Whoever said that to you made a mistake, and I will say that live on my channel in front of 300 people. That is an absolutely terrible thing. That makes me very sad as somebody who streams KSP and wants to get more people to play the game. I'm saying it. I'll say it right now. Tell me who I need to talk to, because that attitude needs to change right there. That attitude absolutely needs to change. That's why people don't play this game. Anyways, smile. Gonna ask. Starts with an I. Sporpian, don't spam stuff. I'm not even firing shots. I'm stating facts. I'm not firing shots. I'm stating facts. Update my list of probes. Oh my gosh. Alright. Cybertech, send me a message and tell me who you were talking to. I'll get that decision changed. That's ridiculous. Oh my gosh. I should make a space plane without a rocket, take it to Minmisen back? Probably not going to happen without a rocket on it. You gotta have a rocket engine of some sort. You totally have to have a rocket engine on a space plane. I don't think it's going to go very well for you if you don't have a rocket engine. In fact, you can make a plane, but you can't actually get it to space. Engineer should absolutely come stock. And if you don't want it, you can disable it, you can turn it off, but Engineer needs to be there stuck. That's why people don't... People are too intimidated by this game and they don't understand what's going on. If it's been a while since somebody's told you that, hopefully my stream can be evidence that that is an absolutely incorrect, incorrect way to do it. Ions? Ah, ions. Haha, that's hilarious. I don't think that's what they were saying, though. You're right, you can definitely do ions, I guess. Flame 385, thanks for the follow. Did that not ring? I didn't hear the ring either. Now I'm just trying not to die. I've just throttled up my engines just a little bit. There's a Julian Periaps. 100. Alright. With a calculator and a few salt crackers. But don't put actual... A plane with rocket engines, but don't put rockets on it. I gotcha. Yeah, I really am casting from outer space. Yeah, that's a very huge problem bearing logic. Trial and error is good, but it is a huge flaw in logic and it needs to be corrected. It absolutely needs to be corrected. I mean, I'll say it. It's something they need to think about. The trial and error is cool, but it frustrates too many people and they don't play the game. Yeah, you're not going to trial and error your way to a Lathe mission. You're not going to trial and error your way to a Grand Tour. You're not going to trial and error your way many places. You'll waste so much time doing that sort of stuff. It leads to major frustration. That makes exactly sense. All right. I think we're good. I don't think that this trajectory tool is really going to be able to show us. Oh, that has us crashing. But for some reason, I can't get close enough. I don't really understand what's going on here. I can't seem to... Yes, I did, Scorpion. Like 20 people answered it for you. Chill out, dude. Seriously? There we go. Focus on Tyla. Let's see if this makes it any better. I just want something in the inner system so that I can... Let's focus on Val. I'm like focusing my way in. Alright, there we go. So that right there has us basically deorbiting, which is not something that we want. Let's see here. Yeah, I'm not time warping. I've got to turn back around again. Will the capture happens before the plane crashes? Yeah, but Tab... Court, that's a good point. Problem is newbies don't really want to know the hook. Yeah, but Mater, that is not a problem with the game or the complexity or engineer. That's a problem with the lack of proper tutorials in the game. The game does not do a good job of walking you through how to play the game. There are a couple wacky tutorials, but they don't explain anything to you. That's what needs to be fixed. Kerbal Engineer needs to be stock in the game, and the tutorials need to be better and show you what the numbers mean. That's why the stream's so successful, because I'm filling the missing hole. I'm filling the gap, right, in Kerbal Space Program right now. I feel very strongly about that. Would engineer, actually, Seraquin, that's a great idea. Like, if you're playing career mode, engineer could be unlocks. You would have to get science and you would have to unlock different pieces of it or something like that. I definitely think that that's, yeah, ignorance is not the way forward. That makes perfect sense. Ignorance is never the way forward. You don't want to keep people ignorant. Yeah. We really... And I would be willing to do some of the tutorials, right? I can do that. It needs to be in the game, and it needs to, like, walk you through how to get to orbit, how to land, how to dock. There's some tutorials there, but they're just not up to snuff, really. Just add the Kerr mode as an option. Eh, that doesn't make any sense. Yeah. Adding it as an option? No, you should be able to use it in all the things. Das Kerman. Alright, let me see if I can fix this. Why did I just turn and burn radial in? I'm an idiot. I'm asked to play a game with the Das Paladins playing KSP BGM on. Yeah, this is a... I think the computer needs to be restarted here. Yeah, you're right. Kerr's used helpful people to get their craft up into space. And, you know, tossing parts together and crashing rockets and doing crazy stuff like that, that's cool. You know, that's cool. It's possible to send the same probe to every planet. Goalie Bear, you can do a grand tour with one thing. I'm trying to turn here. And I'm also trying to read chat and type in chat at the same time.
Oh, yes. Happy using blue screens. Das Kerman would say F5 for safety.
Seraquin, I think that you would unlock the engineer at the very beginning. I think you would get it at the very beginning, but then you could unlock additional functionality in engineer. You know? As you go. I'm still turning, right? Yeah, I'm just turning very slowly. What size and type? Let's see here. Yeah, Galen, that would make a lot of sense. Galen, I think that is a winning idea that you have there, one Galen. If you, like, you could trial your error into different things, then that could unlock stuff. That would be really cool. KR doesn't help with strutting your stuff. an observatory so you can unlock planets. Yeah, Rollo, I mean, if they don't want the game to be a success, they don't have to have the game be a success. I'm just kidding. I mean, that's definitely a harsher statement. But I think that there needs to be better tutorials is the biggest thing. There needs to be better tutorials that explain some of the stock concepts, not just toss engines on rockets and burn constantly. Because the problem, right? The problem with that is that people are tending to do what they see in the movies, right? Do what they see in the movies, and what they see in the movies is wrong. You don't run your engine constantly. There are certain things you do. You know what I mean? Oops, that's the wrong window. They really need to make the game more accessible to more people. To make the game more accessible to more people. That's what I'm doing with my stream. Yes, it is possible to land on planets. Betty Hill tutorials, an up-to-date demo, and Kerbal Engineer stock. Why would you need better tutorials? This isn't rocket science. No, you just slap stuff together and you try to launch it and see if it works or not. No. There we go. That right there is an aero break. That's what I wanted to do. And a beauty shot from Eve. Nice. Yeah, they really don't understand what's happening when they slap engines on. They don't understand anything about orbital mechanics. They do it based on what they see in the movies. And I know I'm issuing some pretty strong opinions, but I'm really passionate about this. Right? I really am passionate about this. Ten Linus, what's up? I think that it'll be more open to more people, and therefore it'll make more people interested in space and awesome stuff if you give them some more information. Don't just make it toss things together and see if it crashes or not. That, like, caters to one sort of audience that will play the game for a day watching it crash and then move on, like we've seen quite a few streamers do, right? They're like, oh, all these people, oh my gosh, it's so awesome, look at them all crashing, blah, 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 and then they move on because it loses its luster after you've crashed rockets for a couple days. All right. I skipped a question. Dark Viper, did I skip a question? Did you say the word question? The science was known for Kerr before anybody even went to space. I like that, Thader. I didn't see your question. Dark Viper, what size? Oh, what size in cloth? I started to answer it, and then I didn't. All right. Let's see here. But they did the math first, Gully Bear. They tested a bunch of rockets, but only after they understood what all of the numbers were. They didn't not have anything. They didn't know what force equals mass times velocity is or anything like that, and then just slap parts together and see if they would fly. That's not how it happened. That's not how that happened. It's basically 2 yards. 2 yards. 2 yards. So it's 3 feet wide and 6 feet long. What Das said on the tutorials is a highlight. Yeah, unlockable information with different bits at a different time. It's not really possible to fit it into a tube because just people... I have to look at that. Needs a basics. That makes perfect sense. A basics physics tutorial. Rollo, I love that idea. I love that idea. Scaletrix, thanks for the follow. I think the message in-game would be important. Like, dear player, if you're interested in more, look at the Focus Forms mod section for awesome stuff. Yeah, something like that. They need to give more information in the stock game. The tools to be successful are just not there in the stock game. And that's why people quit the game so quickly. Because they're just thinking, you get sick of crashing rockets. You get Chris. Force equals, what did I say? I thought I said force equals mass times acceleration. I said force equals mass times velocity or something, didn't I? What did I say? I don't know, I was talking very quickly. I know. It's going to be hard to do, though. The medium where it's like a little cutesy character saying, meh, like that, it's going to be hard to convey some of the concepts of the game. I've looked at a lot of the stuff. I'm actually a beta tester for the Kerbal EDU stuff. Let me, so that I don't turn the wrong way. That's retrograde. And I need to point retrograde. Which is the wrong way. Alright. Oh, I said velocity. Did I say velocity? It's, what is it? Designing crash to build an airship. Wait, what? Now I'm pointing the right way. Now I'm pointing the wrong way. I've got to slip around the other way. Ay, 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 ay. So much for breakfast. Because the lag on this ship is the problem. We got to get rid of more and more parts. EJ learned, yeah, Dirk Diggler, the reason I can explain all this is because I figured it out. I figured it out before I even knew what the Navval was. Why didn't I know what the Navval was? Because there was no tutorial in the game telling me how the Navval worked. The first time I rendezvoused with a craft, I didn't even have the Navval expanded. I had no clue what I was doing. And I rendezvoused and docked with a craft without even knowing about the Navval. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. Yes, some smart people can figure it out, but to make the game more accessible to more people, you need to make it easier for people to understand what's going on in the game. Oh, well, let me turn off my SAS. What is a HUD mod? It's a Nav HUD. The EDU stuff is much... I want to say it the right way. The EDU stuff is much less interesting, I think, because it's designed for an educational environment, but it loses some of its awesomosity because it is for an educational environment. And I really wonder if there's a way that you could do a little bit better with that. You know, it doesn't make sense that things should have to lose some interest just because it's educational. But you've got it's a game, right? And you're trying to overcome the hurdle of convincing educators that people can learn things with the game. You had a bad nightmare, Trevor. That sounds terrible. Do you have videos about you playing the game without knowledge? We could do that. We could totally do something. Well, here's the thing. It wasn't really without knowledge, right? Because I understood the basic concepts, right? I understood some basic concepts because I understand that stuff. That's stuff that I'm interested in. It was really the game didn't tell me how those concepts applied to the game, and so I couldn't map the two. I had to map it by hand using like rudimentary information. I'll do a stream on it one day, but it really is a major failing that the game doesn't give you more information. It does not set you up for success. I would love, Galen, dude, you were definitely in the minority there, because so many people don't understand games, don't understand gaming. They don't think it's serious education and all that sort of stuff. It's a huge thing, you know? All right, let's time warp on down to here. I need to go ahead and get this arrow capture done and or kill everyone. This is in 53 days, apparently. I'm running my mouth about things that I'm passionate about, and I am very passionate about these things. And I think that we could do a lot better job on them. Yeah, right. Probably with RSS far and Dre. What? Why? One Galen, why would you want RSS? You've only got X amount of time in your class. Why would you want to spend more time covering the exact same stuff? Right? It's going to take you more time to do the exact same basic concepts if you have RSS installed. Landing gear were wing pieces. Nice. Could make some really good KSA PSAs that would enhance KSP. That's kind of what we're doing with the stream, you know? Anyways, let's go ahead and time warp. Now, wow, look, time warping is faster when I'm viewing the ship than when I'm in this mode. That's very weird. Time warp. Oh, wow. Look at that glow, though! That is cool. Look at the glow. Oh, man. Look at that underglow. Look at the green Julian underglow. That's a mod I installed. I was just trying it out. I wonder if that's why I'm crashing so much. That green planet shine, though. Look at that. We've got the green albedo off of Jewel. That's freaking cool. But still, it's the same, it's a mod. Yeah, I did install the mod. Still, it's, what would you be covering? And I'm really curious on this, because I don't think that I would ever teach Kerbal Space Academy sessions using RSS, right? Because it's just more time to accomplish the same stuff, to cover the same basic topics. And that's, I'm really interested in what you would gain from using Real Solar System, besides the actual names of the planet and having some actual in-game content describing the real planets and that sort of stuff. I think that's the one thing you would get. Yeah, that would really be more of a, like less physics and more astronomy class, right? But I don't know what you teach. Yeah, there you go. It's Planet Shine. Or no, it's, is it Planet Shine? Which one did I install? If we're on the topic of things the game needs, another Time Warp level. Doesn't it look great, though, with the green underglow? It'd be great if it was nighttime, but then we didn't have Albedo. What are you doing in KSA? It's boot camp day. It's boot camp day today. It's something that might be too hard for some game developers. I'll help. Tell me how I can help. Tell me how I can help. Would be useful for showing real gravity turns. Yeah, I like that. Real solar system plus far. You could do a real gravity turn without it, right? But it's almost like I would want, because I'm limited on class time, right? I would want a real solar system that uses the real planets but doesn't have the scaling up. You know what I mean? Like, without the scaling up, so that we, when we're doing things in class, it doesn't take us as long to get them done. But we still are able to... I really hope this thing... We better F5 for safety right now. We may be dead already. It puts far more emphasis on requiring... In Cybertech, that's a really important context. Robata, what's going on? Similar solar system. They should call it similar solar system. Bye, I love it. The small scale RSS, because then you would have the real... You could have the real planets, you could have real facts about the planets, we could have real historical missions that go to the planets, but it just wouldn't take the same amount of time, right? Kerbin-sized RSS, yeah. SSS. Similar solar system. The glow behind you looks like a window. You're right, it is. There's a glow behind me. I don't think so. 4-1, I do not believe. I do not believe that RSS with Kerbin scale, that would make a lot of sense. RSS with Kerbin scale would be awesome. And then at different historical times, you could reenact missions. Like, you could reenact the file, and you could go through it. And you could see how closely the kids reenacted the mission profile or whatever. Because then you have reference materials. You have to look stuff up, right? You have to see what happened in the mission. You would read what was going on. You could do Apollo 13, Apollo 11, Apollo whatever. You could do whatever you wanted. Oh my gosh. Saying dead. Saying dead is a good way to get the attention of lurkers. All right. Yeah, no, I'm arrow breaking, guys. I'm totally arrow breaking. Let me go ahead and focus on my ship. I am definitely arrow breaking right now. I don't know what the deal with that periapsis is, but I guess we're just going to go with it. It's like flattened for some reason. That's not right. Oh, well, let's see if we all die or not. The FASA mod and reacting Apollo 11. Dead? Your big mission is about to happen. Yeah. We are supposed to be losing. Hi, guys. We're not in orbit yet. RSS with Kerbin scale and the FASA pack. That would be cool. Although, I don't even think I would use the FASA pack. I don't think I would use the FASA pack. I would let the kids build similar rockets using different components. I wouldn't just want them to put together the rockets using the parts that were made to match the actual rockets. I would want them to build something analogous to the actual rockets using the Legos that they have in the game already. I think that that would be a little bit better experience. Let's see if we all die or not. I should probably just fast forward till I get into the atmosphere. You guys are probably dead, by the way. I'm just going to point that out. Everybody's probably dead. But, I mean, I really do know. I really do know that that's kind of some holy war stuff. But my big thing is this is an awesome game, and I want people to be interested in it, because building sorts of excitement and interest and stuff like that in STEM topics is very important to me, right? And it's going to be good for us as a society if we build support for that sort of stuff. And I want to further that as I can, and I know how to play the game, and I know how to talk a lot, apparently. Giving Tiz the mission parameters would be awesome, yeah. KW Rocketry. And the students make their own craft. Yeah, that would be awesome. Like, build your own craft to get close using the parts that you have. KW is one of the very few. Really? Parts mods. I've never used KW. I mean, I think you can do just about everything you want in the game, but a lot of people love it. A lot of people love it. There's a 1/10 scale solar system for RSS, MC2599, nice. Thought it would be more like real life when it came to rockets. More like real life, interesting. Stock crafter generally poorly built anyways, intentionally. Are we arrow breaking yet? We're still, oh, here we go. Here we're starting to get some heating effects. All right, you guys. I hope you guys live through this. I hope we don't need like a million G's worth of deceleration here. Fair. All right, I'm back. I pulled my headphone out. Fairings would definitely be nice in stock. Shh. I'm awake, alarm. I'm awake. So we're, you know, just, look at that. As soon as the atmospheric calculations kicked in, I got physics lag again. Yeah, no, I just pulled it out. Headset, mic, everybody's like, what? Fairings should be stuck. That would be cool. Did Dusk keep the LES on the ship? The LES. I don't think so. Fairings will hopefully be in stock when they upgrade their supodynamics to aerodynamics. Nice. Yeah, a wired headset? No, it wasn't that. It was the wire that got me. I need a completely wireless. I'm sorry I made you angry enough to mute yourself, says Dirt Diggler. Thank you, Dirt Diggler. Wow, we're getting some serious physics lag here. But we're definitely aero capturing. I think. I hope so. Ah, nice! Aero captured. Now please just don't kill everybody. Our altitude is still decreasing, and we're already at capture. I hope this altitude perks up here, because we really need to get out of the atmosphere now. We're not even to the periaps, but the periaps is 12 seconds away. War Wizard and Skelectric. Thanks for the follows, guys. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Time for you to go, Lucifer. The power of time for you to go compels you. All right. Look at this. It's just like a really great, call it super slow-mo for added visual effect. Yeah, you're right. I did build a big ship here. Dan for rescue. Rovers are totally... They're awesome to, like, build a rover, but the planets are very big and full of places to drive. And rovers take so long. Rovers, trust in the trajectory mod. Some of those rovers, man, they just take so long to drive. There you go. Join. Wow, we just got tons of joins all of a sudden. It's 100% gas giant, Mercenary Blue. It is 100% gas giant. No place to land. Hey, you seen yesterday the mod. It's not always right. True Indian Chief, I don't get that. Imagine KSP is based on a true story. What do you mean? I don't understand that. Astro Coop, I'm not done. Ten Linus, thanks for the follow. Oh. What's better than rovers? Airships. Slow-mo is better than what we had before it was implemented. It would skip frames of the physical trajectory to explode randomly. Really? That doesn't sound like a good thing. I'm just going to go ahead and physics warp through this. Wait a second. Look at that. We had a Val encounter there for a second. I'm going to warp all the way out and see if there's not something I can do to a rendezvous with Lathe right now. Too much wind, yes. Goldie Bear, be back in 2 hours. Cool. KSP TV. What? Oh, were we hosted by KSP TV? Oh, well, thanks to KSP TV for hosting the stream. Thank you, KSP TV. Are we out of the atmosphere yet? Yes, we are. Okay. So now, KSP TV, whoever you are, thanks for the host. Okay. So can we get a Lathe encounter on the way back around? Lathe is going to be there when we're there. What if we burn retrograde right now? Let's play with our orbit a bit. And what if we burn retrograde right now? Can we get Lathe? Alright, so that wouldn't be another capture. Aiden Appleclark, good morning! What's going on, yo? So that's basically just getting it farther ahead of us. So that's not really it. So the best thing to do may be just to go circular. I mean, I don't think that even burning radial in is going to help me right there. That's just going to waste lots and lots of delta V. See how close we can get to it. It's never an efficient maneuver to burn radial in like that. So you can do it, but I bet you this is going to be freaking buku delta V. Watch. Yep. There you go. There's a lathe encounter right there. Sweet. So, how much delta V? 3,889. Radial in is never the answer. Radial in is never the answer. Oh my goodness. Too much. Yeah, radial in is never the answer, y'all. Just keep that in mind. This is probably going to be the thing to do. Setting that second arrow break there. So coming around for another arrow break, basically. So that my node looks like this. I wonder if this works. I've never tried this before. Look, I'm going to set a maneuver node that is about the delta V that I'll get from the arrow break. You see that? I've never tried this. And then I'll set another maneuver node to see if I can't get a lathe encounter by circularizing up here. Well, this isn't the right place to do it, though. It's okay. It's a 70-ton airship. What? What are you talking about, Darth Hamburger, all of a sudden? Alright, so the next time we come around, lathe will be way over there. Interesting. So that's not what we want at all. Alright, so we'll be there and lathe will just be there. So that means that we would have to burn somewhere around here. Watch. See how that works? Bam, there should be a lathe encounter. But we could probably do it for a lot less delta V. I wonder if this is going to work. I've never tried it before. We'll be there and lathe will be there. So look at this, even less delta V. OMG. Shh. I told you, I woke up. That's my second alarm. Hobbits have second breakfast. Das Valdez has second alarm. The game is not happy with me right now. Excuse me. Does anybody think this is gonna work? That is a retrograde lathe encounter. Look at that. So basically what I'd want to do... I wonder if I can meet it on the way up. It's a cool trick with a node matching trajectories. Yeah. I don't know if it's gonna work. We'll see. You'd be better adjusting in your current ApoApps. What now? Trusting your orbit from Apo. Huh? Wait, this seems to be working. Of course you can, Dust Hamburger. Go for it. Orbit effect isn't taken into account, DK, because KSP doesn't calculate exhaust velocity physics. Let's see here. So see, I'm trying to see what I can do to get that lathe encounter. But I'd rather not go up and above the orbit like that, you know? That's me loitering and waiting for it. That means that I could go a lot less delta V. I mean, I just need my Apo to be right there at lathe's Apo. Then I need to burn at a different time. Because I want to hit it on the way up. That's what I want right there. That's what I want. And if we could get it even lower... What is that? That's weird. Alright, then I could burn a little bit earlier. There we go. Then we could put less Delta V into it. If this even works, I don't even know if this is going to work, right? We'll definitely give it a try. So that's a Lathian slingshot. It's interesting. Oh, because that's my second node, Delta V. Periap 680. We're going to have to recalculate this thing when we come around, you know? When we come around. There we go. That looks fantastic. 443, and we can deal with the rest of it in post, can't we? We just burn less and less. Yeah, the bigger that other, the bigger the red circle gets, the closer we're getting to lathe, so we're getting more of a slingshot effect. Why does the stream title say soon? Because it's not boot camp yet. 393. Alright, I think I'm just gonna roll with that. Oh, we're gonna need an inclination change as well. Look at this. So I'll give myself a little bit of angry triangle here. That's us hitting lathe, apparently. Ain't nobody got time for that. Yes, we don't want to hit lathe. As it turns out, they frown on that. I don't know, guys on the ship, do y'all want to hit lathe? There we go, a 49 kilometer lathe. That's excellent. Is anyone on DOS drink duty? You are. Got it. Got it. Okay, so we have two maneuvers to do here. Do we have the Delta V for these maneuvers? Wow, 839 for the first maneuver? Ouchie. Why is the node in T minus 2 days? Why is the room gone? Alright. So the best thing to do is to set an alarm for this guy, right? We're going to arrow break again into this other orbit, and then we're going to try to use a node on that orbit to get ourselves up to lathe. Change arrow break in current orbit to have a bigger orbit around Joule. Oh, that'll save Delta V. Oh, well that's... Yes, you are correct. I should have been doing that all along. Dude, our Brimmer totally got my back there. I almost just want to burn it, though, but that is an excellent plan. That is that what Cybertech was telling me earlier that I didn't quite get? So freaking laggy. Yeah, we'll do another to get an Apoaps at Lathe's orbit. Yes, you guys, that is a great idea. I was just playing around because I came up with that wacky idea, and that is the right thing to do. You guys are absolutely correct. The right thing to do is this. Like that. And we may get a lathe encounter without even doing anything. Oh, come on. And then we're gonna have to have an inclination change on lathe, and we can do that down there. Because we'll be going faster? No, we'll want to be doing it right here. This is in 2 days. This is after we come around again. But we're not here yet. I should probably just burn normal right now. Alright. That actually looks fantastic. You guys are absolutely right. I don't know why I wasn't thinking that. I had that idea and then I just kind of ran with the idea. But this is the correct thing to do. And then we'll have to fix the inclination somewhere. But I don't really want to fix the inclination down here at the descending node. It's probably going to cost me a lot. A little bit over the fix. Let's see. And why am I pulling anti-normal at the descending node? MeagleNet! Thank you. Go get you some food. There's a flip. 0.3, that's probably good enough. And I wonder what that node's going to cost me. Wouldn't it be great if there was a list of nodes 600 meters per second of Delta V to do the plane change? Heh, that's probably not the place to do that. The proper place to do that is probably over here, but that is going to cause massive problems with our aero brake. Let's see here. This is not in 2 days. I want it in less than 2 days. Early morning, KSP. Call me Kobe. New account. What's going on, man? Or Kobe, since I'm supposed to call you Kobe. This isn't going to work. Yeah, That's the orbit I'm on right now. Yeah, ambulatory. That's why I was putting it down there. Because I was like, just land. No, true Indian chief. I'm going to do this when I do this. Go watch people headshot people. I will land. Yeah, where the orbits intersect. At some point to change aero brake. At same point to change aero brake. You think so? I don't think that that's going to be the right place. It's too far off. Maybe we can do a little bit there. That would do some, I guess. Negative 2.5, but there's no way we can completely match it. That is at least going to... It's kind of hard to see what's going on here. Between that and the lag, it is a little bit difficult. And now the game won't let me pull on nodes. See, because the way that the game does the... Yeah, the game is very, very, very bad about letting you change inclination, normal, anti-normal, and burn prior trajectory at the same time. I'm just going to do this live. Go watch people who headshot people. JJ Witt and I have not been up all night. F5 for safety before we do all these shenanigans. And let's see if we can do this. Whoa. That guy in the middle, though, he needed to be strutted in a little bit, didn't he? The science lab. Up! That science lab totally needs to be strutted in. Look at it, wiggling and wobbling. Okay. That seems legit right there. I'm gonna do this live. Oh, that's a good one, Brimmer. But you have to put the name in. Plane change at intersect nodes. Dear God, just think about the efficiency. Yeah, that's what I was actually trying to do, but the game was not allowing me to put a maneuver here. Which is the next point. There we go. Now I can put a maneuver here. Pancakes! What's going on? Oh, because that's showing... Oh. That's showing the ascending or descending node relative to the purple orbit? Yes. Relative to the resultant purple orbit. Alright. So, it's just the game hiccuping on us. It does not understand what we're trying to do. We need to get rid of that node. We need to do... Yeah, look at that. Our descending node is out there. Here's our ascending node up here. Alright, let's do this. Do this thing one at a time. Let's come over here and do a plane change maneuver. Right like that. To come into Laith's plane. And look at that. That single maneuver is also... Look at that. That single plane change maneuver is also getting us the Lathian aerobrake orbit. You see that? That's probably the way to do it right there, folks. That is probably the way to do it right there. Because in the game, pulling normal and anti-normal isn't truly... isn't truly normal or anti-normal. It's not. Because it applies it all on the same vector, and your normal and anti-normal changes as you burn, right? You have to follow it around. The game doesn't know what we're trying to do. Well, it doesn't! The game doesn't know what we're trying to do. No. Why is it not making noises? That's weird. Did it not pop up? I see it here in the stream tip alerter, but why did it not pop up? Are we getting the error again? No, the donation thing is totally up. Donation notify right there. And it's not airing out. Dude, Astra Coop, because you're a very cool person, I like to watch your stream, even when I have no plan of what you're doing there. Best regards from Germany, Bavaria. Again, Marcus, dude, Astra Coop, thank you for the donation, man. I appreciate it. I do, but I don't know why that didn't go off. I'm gonna have to I think the entire computer needs to be rebooted or something like that. Guys, give some hype for Astra Coop. Sent a little tip. Donation alert offline. Look right there. I don't know what the deal with that is, but Astra, thank you so much for that. I do appreciate that. That science lad must be safe for chemical? What? Nice. Thank you, Astra. I appreciate it. And greetings from over here. Greetings from North Carolina, USA, is where I am right now. All right. Let's go ahead and do this alarm. Add an alarm. Thank you again, Astra. Thank you for saying that. Shatters are better than pop-ups. Ambulatory cortex, we're on the same page. We're on the same page. A middle of a donation hype. Nice. All right, 2 hours. Let's go ahead and get this done, guys. We're taking too long. We've been having a lot of cool discussions and stuff, I think, as well. I didn't get it exactly on the ascending node. What are you going to do, sue me? Okay, I don't get it. Now I don't have lag in this screen. It is kind of like slow motion. It's easier to do more precise burns whenever you're lagging out. See? 0.3, 0.2. All right. Now we have the Lathian Aero Break. We're coming up into Lathe's Aerospace there. We're going to go around again. And we aero braked ourselves. That was 50 meters per second of Delta V. Everything is breaking. I'm going to need donations so I can go get breakfast. And it's 10:30. No, I'm going to have to go to the Pancake House place. From California. Sherman, what's going on? All right. Let's go through the aero break. Hello again, awesome dude. Icecraft Platinum Twitch. What's going on? It's running a petabyte in a page file. Cybertech, do you need some more RAM, man? What sort of RAM do you need to match? No, don't catch me. Vol, go away. I'm leaving. I don't want an influence. No, go. Just don't catch me. Whew. Vol was hot on my tail. Did anybody see that? Cybertech, I'm about to send you some RAM for Christmas, man. I don't know what to tell you. But I am about to send you some RAM for Christmas. Alright, F5 for safety. Excellent. Alarm's off. Cybertech, I was thinking about Engineer, and I was wondering if there was a way to pause Engineer so that it did no calculations, like a button you could press. Because doesn't it keep doing the calculations even if you do that? Or does that actually pause Engineer? Like if I press backslash and I take it off the... Val was all swiggity, swiggity, swooty. Does that pause the calculation so Engineer uses no, stuff and stuff? It seems like I'm not in the craft anymore. You should be there. Remember, it just doesn't give a full list. You're in there. Yeah, we haven't gotten rid of anybody. You didn't get away that easily. Where are you at, though? Wait. Rychex is in here. Mobile processing lab. Where are you? Oh, no, there you are. You're in there. You're on there. You're at the bottom of the list. If no readouts are being shown, then no calculations are done. Thank you, Cybertech. I've been wondering that for a while. First targeted landing to save the Kerbal from the other night. Dude, Convio, congratulations. First targeted landing to save... That is a much more safe lander, looks like the second version. And you had a... Dude, you had a freaking solar eclipse at the same time that you're doing the rescue? That's cool. That is freaking awesome. Congratulations. Good job, K. There you go. Cybertech is the brains of the steam. I don't understand that one, True Indian Chief. How much was a subscription again? $250. A subscription to what? The subscription to what? What were we talking about, Casper? Mother is putting up Christmas decorations. Cool. That's legit. All right. Everybody likes that. Here we go, arrow breaking again. We're just using the upper reaches of the atmosphere this time to take a little bit of delta V, to take a little bit of velocity, energy out of our orbit, and break our way down. Look at that. It's going to be there. I wonder if we're going to catch up. We just have a little bitty slight arrow break, and we're trying to come up the backside. Ram. Ram from a friend who raises ram at a server farm upstate. A wild Casper appeared. Coming right up and get your ISP. What? Oh my gosh. I don't know what's going on with that. Yeah, Casper, what's up? Oh, a monthly sub for a Twitch channel is $4.99. It's $4.99, Casper, is what Twitch charges for a subscription. $4.99. Are we getting closer? We are getting closer to it. Look at us closing in on Lathe. We may have to burn retrograde a little bit. Yuli slave made ram. What? I don't understand that. But we are getting a closer and closer encounter with Lathe here. Lathe. From just a couple arrow breaks and 50. Stream. The entire chat is my stream brain. I totally appreciate everybody hanging out. That's get your delta V for anybody who doesn't know the rocket equation. Your ISP times 9.81 times the natural log of mass 0 times mass 1. That would be the empty mass and the full mass, I guess. Can you maybe give some tips for beginners? Kissing. After I ate lunch, I'm going to do Kerbal Boot Camp. When I do Kerbal Boot Camp, I will definitely give some tips for beginners in Kerbal Space Program. That's kind of my thing. It's kind of what I do. So look, now I wonder, is burning retrograde right here going to help us? JSB, thanks for the follow. Is burning retrograde? Nope. So that kind of hosed us a little bit. That kind of hosed us. We're going to have to fix this. Eek. We hosed ourselves by doing that low maneuver like that. We're fine. I wonder if a little bit of radial in will help us. That is not getting us any closer. And that is going to be way too much delta V to do a maneuver like that. 500, 600. So 663, it's like we didn't actually save anything. We braked right there at Lathe's orbit. What if we just wait? What if we circularize right here and we wait for Lathe to come back around again? Because 663 is not an efficient way to do this. What if we did it more up here? I don't think that this is going to be good at all. To get a Lathe encounter here, it's going to be more than 600, I believe. Let's try some things, though. Yeah, look at that. Okay, so if we did it even sooner, we could get a Lathe encounter. That's 825. But all we really get for the Lathe encounter is that right there. Gives all the tips in boot camps. That's what I do. You don't have to pay. In general, I hear the landing on the moon is harder than Minmus. Why? The moon is a larger body and has higher gravity. It takes more delta V to land and more delta V to take back off again. So Minmus is definitely the place that I say to go to do your landing drills. Maybe we should just get ourselves out of the atmosphere and then wait for Lathe to come around again. That's probably what we should do. I don't like it much, but that is probably what we should do.
Solid disconnected from 91.3.
Oh, maybe I could kill TeamSpeak. I don't really need that anymore.
Disconnected.
There we go. Disconnect that. What's going on with that? That's weird. It's not doing anything there. Because we don't really want to arrow break again. But this is not a very different orbit. We'll just get up out of the atmosphere. There you go. 150 should be out of the atmosphere. We'll come around again and we'll get Lathe on the next pass. 3.5 meters per second. And make a tiny burn sooner for a Lathe encounter later. Yeah. That's what we're going to do after I get up out of the atmosphere here. Let's just put an alarm and time warp. I guess, I wonder if it takes me a lot longer to get to places because I totally talk to people while I'm doing this. Yeah, the biggest challenge on Minmus is accidentally not putting yourself into orbit. Or is making sure you don't accidentally put yourself into orbit. Look at Lathe. We're definitely going out there. We'll be coming around. Tipping your lander over and not being able to ride it. in Trichos, what's going on? If you're tipping your lander over, you're having trouble, go ahead and... Das Valdez and nobody else. I love it. What was I saying? Oh my gosh. Oh, tipping over. You need a wider wheelbase, basically. A wider lander base. A little teeny... Gosh, we're so close to lathe. How is this not a lathe encounter? I don't understand. There's bound to be a way that I can turn this into a lathe encounter. I mean, we're just right there. Look at this. We're so freaking close. Where's lathe at? I'm gonna get rid of this. No, I said get rid of that. There we go. We're gonna be there. And lathe is gonna be where? Nowhere. Over there? Yeah, I don't buy that. You need to be right now, not in a day or whatever. Let's see, is there anything I can do? Could I accelerate to get to lathe? Nope. It's gonna move out of the way. That's not a valid strategy. Could I decelerate to get to lathe? We already know that that's not going to work. Could I turn inwards to get to lathe? We're so close. Try retrograde. I just tried retrograde, and that didn't get it. It's got to be radial in. And prograde. Yeah, no. How? Oh my gosh. How far away from lathe are we? We're almost on top of it. I wonder, can we cut the inside? Pro, retro, and radial. Pro, retro, and radial. Huh. I wonder if we can come up here. Because see, even that, even if we go radial, we're going to have to catch up to it. Because it's already ahead of us, you know? And that's where you get radial in. Radial in from up here allows you to kind of cut on the inside of the track, right? That's not what we want. That's not what we want. Here's what we want. Look, I think we could do it this way. If we did, like, a little bit of radial in over here, maybe. We could come up lathe's tailpipe, I guess. But that's not what we're going to want. Boost the bit at Apo to change your orbital period. Yeah, but then we could go around and around and around and around again. That's what I'm trying not to do. We're so close to it right now. Look at that. Okay, but that's 700. We're trying all sorts of different stuff here, so let's do this. Let's go here, let's add maneuver. Bingo, but that's 1,000. Now, I think the most cost-effective solution... I think the most cost-effective solution here is going to be to, aero brake right at lathe. Just like we had before, and then just wait for an encounter that's closer. So just go ahead and put this up like that. 155, yeah, that's going to be the most efficient thing to do. Lathe is so close, you guys can see it. Look, I bet you Shimmy can see it. No, Shimmy can't see it. Hmm. Well, that means that Shimmy is not, he's in here. And if we wanted to, we could transfer him to this pod. Now Shimmy can see it. There you go. And a strut. His view of a strut. Oh my gosh, okay. 14 hours. Yeah. You're right. Why are you not doing a basic circularized Hohmann transfer? Too expensive in this case, because I'm not. Pull the non-existent e-brake and slide in. Speed Kerman, what's going on? Yeah, we're already in an elliptical orbit, so we can't set up a Hohmann transfer, a basic Hohmann transfer. Let's just go ahead and get this done. Oh no, I went IVA so that it changed my control from here. There we go. This is coming up in 2 hours. Let's just go ahead and get this done. Yeah, relative to its physical size, it looks so close, but you're not in an encounter. You're exactly right. That is exactly what we're dealing with here. Now where'd it go? Did it get further away? Look, it's right there! Look at the dark side of lathe. Oh my gosh, look at all the planets! Look at that. That's going to be Lathe, Jewel, that should be Val, and is that Tylo? I think those are the only ones that would be that big. You took your basic Docker design and made an SSTO out of it. Nice, Speed. Post up a picture. Look at this screenshot, though. That is cool. That is cool. So let's go ahead and get this done. Oh yeah, I'm supposed to burn. Oops. Fashion. Should be okay. Are we out of the atmosphere? What's our parry? 156? Yeah, we're fine. Okay, so now Setlaith is the target. And just come down here. And what if I just right-click on this node and I wait in orbit? Wait in orbit. Oh, every time it's getting a little further away from us. Y'all see that? Then we're coming together. And there's a Lathe encounter. If we just wait 23 days, we're good to go. Why is that 23 days? That doesn't make a lot of sense. If we just waited 23 days, we could have a Lathe encounter with a 71-kilometer periaps for no delta V. Yeah, you'd have to go faster. You're right. Yep, you're right. No, Sura. Welcome to my stream. That's how I roll. So why is that... Huh, interesting. So let's see here. If we go here, we're gonna do a wait node like that. And then we're going to do an actual maneuver node after it, like this. And what we're gonna do is change our orbital period just a little bit until we're right there at Lathe. Wow, I've never seen two nodes expanded at the same time. I thought it wouldn't do that. I guess that's what happens when you have a... Okay. See, that's good. That's got us right there. Basic Docker SSTO. Whoa! Tiny URL, do you speak it? I'll look at it in just a second. Let me figure out the math on this. Oh my gosh, what? That's odd. I didn't tell it to do that. 3 hours, one day. Get back over here. There's not even any delta V in this maneuver node. Why would it do that? Are we gonna change every time we go around? That doesn't make any sense. That's too low now. Okay, having two maneuver nodes close to each other seems like it's confusing the heck out of the game. Why don't I just wait on this node? Bam! There we go. Now we're good. Now we've got a Lathe encounter. With a periaps of 200. I can deal with that all day long, y'all. I can deal with that all day long. Slightly awkwardly placed claws. Wait, what? You get the demo of Steam. Do it! Get it, no sir. Get the demo, dude. Wow. Got intakes much? You're not going to be detecting very many tachyons with that thing. No, I've got it set so that it always displays the trajectories. But that's... I can deal with that right there. I can deal with this. We'll just fix this live. Look at that. Them patch conics, though. Okay. This is coming up in 3 hours, so we'll have this Lathe encounter pretty soon. And the good news is we don't really have to turn around, which is good. So let's add an alarm. Oops. I wanted breakfast so bad. Streamed right through breakfast. Astropilot, what's going on? The claws are just aesthetic. You know what else is... Oh, look at that glow, though. Look at that green glow from Jewel. That looks so cool. So we've used, what, like 60 plus 60 delta V or something? 50 plus 60 delta V? My headset may die. Then we have another burn coming up in 3 days, it says. Oh, headset's died. So let me go ahead and orient to this other node. Ah, what mod makes the jewel light? It is, Shine, Planet Shine. Seriously, this node is running from me. I hate it when nodes do that. But we should be good, and I'll add an alarm. And I'm gonna go ahead and time warp up to it. This is 3 days from now. So that's our maximum time warp right there. All right, let me get my headset batteries here. Yes, Gav, I am going to go get lunch. I am going to go get lunch. Oh my gosh, it's going to slow my time warp every time I come around. Oh, we were so close to the lathe that time.
Patience, young Padawan.
You forgot to put life support in your rescue craft. Alright, this is gonna be time to burn the node here, it looks like. Yeah, my biggest thing with the intake hogging is that, when it doesn't look real, like it looks like there's no way that it could possibly work that way, that kind of gets me, that kind of gets me the stuff. Oh my goodness. I don't know what to tell you. Good times though, good times. Gotcha, Gav. I gotcha. No worries. It looks like no burn is needed for an encounter. Really? Oh, yeah, you're right. No burn is needed for an encounter. Is it a better encounter, I wonder? Crashing into the planet. No burn is needed to crash into the planet. Some burn is needed to not crash into the planet. Actually, it looks like a prograde burn would have been better, but I'm already pointed this way. There we go. There's a periaps. All right. Did I miss anything else? I think I'm all good. Fuel savings is a big deal. Entire program of ketane. Are you going to put a ketane refinery like right outside the pad and like only fuel your ships using a ketane refinery? Gotcha. Okay. My stream won't load KSP for you. What? Your Steam won't load KSP for you? What does that mean? That doesn't sound good. So now I need to get into lathe here. Focus view. How are we passing lathe? Not great, honestly. He is in a prograde orbit, it looks like. Tick for me. Tick for me. Yeah, he's in a prograde orbit. So we need to fix this. My last big mission to Duna is working in Duna orbit. Let me see this. Whoa! I like the dock together stages on the end. I like the dock together stages. That is a very, STS. Vermin von Kerman, STS sort of setup. So if I burn right here. That's what we needed to do. Excellent. And then we'd also need to give it some anti-retrograde, right? Or no, some retrograde apparently. And that is 12,000, so let's turn our trajectories mod back on. I wish this had a keyboard shortcut. Maybe it does now. Alright, now it's not showing us what's going to happen because we're not on the right SOI right now. There we go. If anything, we're definitely going to bleed a lot of velocity off in this aero brake here. See, that is us crashing for sure. And what I want is for there not to be a red X on the planet. Is there still a red X? No, I don't see it. That would mean that we would be aero-braked. But I'll just go ahead and do that. Alright, I think we're good. The camera is normal. Wait, is the camera lower high? What? Good morning, D-Templar. What's going on? Look at it and say potatoes. What? It's almost done so I can get some sleep. Snuggly Squid, are you still here? Oh my gosh. Oh, dear Jesus. Ain't nobody got time for that. F5 for safety. Cantav's got my back. I appreciate you. So this is going to be the biggest burn so far. We've spent 100... We're basically getting this lathe encounter for 200 meters per second of Delta V. You've been up all night watching? This is the European stream before the boot camp stream. There will be a lunch break. That is right. There's going to be a lunch break and then on to boot camp. All right. 35 minutes. Add alarm. Let's get this done, y'all. It's going to be an 11-second burn. There's a minute out. So we basically just need to be a T-minus 6. 9, 8, 7, 6. And now we are just burning Angry Triangle to tweak our orbit down a little bit. So what's that periaps at? 29, and ours is at what? It wanted us to be at what? Whoa. Ah, that is an aero break at lathe. Look at that. I like it. I'm a streaming animal. I'm doing it for a living, Casper. I'm doing it for a living. What the heck in the world? You updated? How long have you been streaming? I've been streaming right now for about, what, 8 hours, I think. We're fine. I'm doing it for a living. This is my weekend to make money. I usually do some pretty good donations at boot camp. So every other weekend. Remember, I take 4 days off every other week, and I don't get paid during those days. So, you know how it is. I'm going to think a teensy tiny bit of radial in whenever we get there should tweak us exactly the way we want. That's radial out. 8 hours, 50 minutes, says our Brimmer. Where does it say that? Does it say that somewhere, our Brimmer? Oh, this is going to be the wrong radial in. Snuggly Squid, they said that I wasn't good enough. They totally said that I was not big enough to get a donation button or a transcoder button or whatever. Whatever. I'll need to turn to the correct radial in whenever I get there. Look at that. we're gonna come in behind and we're gonna slingshot around Lathe. Do you see how? Look, this was the Connex things. Our orbit was going like this, and we're gonna keep on going towards Lathe and pass it like that. And right now, it thinks we're gonna get slingshotted. 200 some viewers, not big enough. I think it's actually the game. Yeah, don't subscribe. If you want to subscribe, just send me a donation straight to me for $4.99. Oh, when you use chatting and click channel, it shows your uptime. I did not know that. Cool. Who knew? I am definitely going to go get me some lunch, though. Cybertech, you're not even kidding. Slingshot! Yes, weedum, that's what we're going to do, a slingshot. I don't want to do a slingshot, though. I want to stay here. So we have to correct this. Will this craft be available for download? You want this craft? What? Oh, Bremer knew. Okay. Wait. Am I not in the sphere of influence yet? I'm not.
Gosh, that was my problem. I can see none of the info below the stream. That's weird. A couple people have said that, Cantab.
A couple people have said that. That is radial out. You may need to click a thing. Yes, I have no subs because I don't want Twitch. Twitch doesn't want to get half the money, I guess, is their problem. Twitch does not want to get half the money from the people who would subscribe. I don't know what to tell you. I don't know, some people have been complaining about that. I don't know what the deal is. But we need to burn just a teeny tiny bit of radial in, and radial in will decrease our periaps, and that should make us aero break even harder. Which is definitely what we want to do. You seem to have to click things. The mic is crystal clear. Judo toss you. This is an old school headset. It is an old school headset. It's a Turtle Beach X31 Xbox headset. How much do we trust this? Who trusts their life to Lathe? Arrow breaking. I'm watching an advertisement for a toothbrush that has Bluetooth technology. What? I don't even know what that means. I don't even know what that means. You want a copy of this craft for download? Refresh the page. Deck. Nice Daz-K it was. All right. Better than yellow tooth. F5 for safety, I'll do it again. So let's just do this. There's pro grade. It actually turns pretty well. Once we start burning the fuel out of it and stuff, it turns pretty well. Now the real question is this landing situation going to work? We may have to land things a little bit differently than we expected. Get the Red X on land. You act like you paid for a landing on land. I don't recall getting any monies from you in terms of this trip. You need to give us some kerbucks, and then you can choose where you land. All right. Only byproduct. What's going on? 20 hours or only product. Huh. Welcome. Been 20 hours worth of watching. That's awesome. F5 for safety here. Got it. Nav it off. And let's just go ahead and do our aero break here. The Kerbal currency is snacks. What is that, Val out there? Now we're in the atmosphere. We're beginning our aero brake maneuver. I don't even know if we're going to get a... I know, we have so much fuel. Look, these drop tanks are still totally full. I don't know. We brought a lot more than we needed. You know how long I've been watching? 4 hours. Congratulations. Is that right, D-Templar? It's halfway between just capture and lowest stable orbit. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense, yes. Estimate the height to plug into a calculator checking its trajectories. in low stable orbit. It's on the wiki, I think. It's on the wiki, I believe. We're gonna crash. We're not gonna crash yet. We're not gonna crash yet. Hey, there's some land. That's good. We've got that going for us. We need land on the daytime side. No, I'm not... What do you mean am I crashing into Kerbin? I'm not crashing into anything. I'm arrow capturing at Lathe. Please land me on land. I'll give you a Snickers. You have to go your job today and tomorrow. The blacklist filter is working fine. You are correct, man. I really like... Thank you for helping me out with that, by the way. A day on your channel. I know I've been through his bootcamp streams and stuff. Yeah. So look at this. We just have a little bit of heating up here. We're barely even doing anything. Do we have any lathe shine on us? Nope. We don't have any real lathe shine on us, it doesn't look like. Maybe a teeny tiny bit. Some land is good. Adequate land would be better. Let's see if you guys are going to die. You may. You never know. Whoa, what was that? Lieutenant Haas, because the extra 2 cents are mine to give. Thanks for the work you do. Dude, Lieutenant Haas, thank you for that donation. That was the same as a 1 month subscription, except that's what I would get from 2 months worth of subscriptions. Thank you for that. That is amazing. I appreciate it. And I heard the sound go off. Did it display in the stream? That was LT Haas. LT Haas, or Lieutenant Haas is what I always keep saying. Thank you again. I appreciate the support. Donation hype. It looks like it appeared. Sweet. Thank you, LT. Uh-oh. Keithane is coming into my room. The sun's coming up. That natural lighting. Oh, it didn't come up on the screen. Really? You heard the sound, but no pop-up? Donation notifies there. It's not hidden behind the chat background. I wonder if it's busted again. Because yesterday we were having troubles with Nightbot. Not on the screen, but no worries, you're welcome. What? Nightbot picked it up. I don't know what the deal with that is. That's weird. I look blue. Let's go ahead and get through this. I think you guys are good. Those Aurorae at the top. Twitch logs me out sometimes. Thanks you for keeping me entertained. I appreciate that, only byproduct. I have the most credits. I totally win. That's not land. Hey, it's close to land. It's close. There's some land down there. That looks like some good land. There's some land where we could land. Where should we land? Can't really land on the night side. Maybe this island here is good? Will we survive Planetfall? I don't know. Das, will we survive Planetfall? Find out in the next Kerbal Space Academy. Okay, there we go. So, should we just shoot for the interior of that continent right there? That doesn't look too bad. That looks like a nice big area where we could land. The action, of course I am. I'm good. Land on land. That's a fairly big island, yeah. Alright, we'll just land it maybe somewhere over here. Like on the edge. Do y'all trust my landing skills enough to get you here on this kind of area? Hoping that it's flat there? We'll see. Lace has some pretty steep terrain. Yeah, we'll F5 before we do the landing. F5 for safety. Alright. Alright. And what I wanted to actually do... Let's land on the coast. Alright, we'll try for that. We will try for that. The trick is... What is that Apo? 200? I'll just go ahead and leave this guy in a 200 orbit with tons and tons of fuel up here. And someday some craft with a claw will have to come and tap it. .203, .201, that's good enough. My landing skills are amazing. Expert Army Ranger, you probably just jinxed this entire mission. Everyone's gonna die, and I blame you. My lathe boat could go.